Tributes pour in for the founder and publisher of Dahong Filipino as the first business and community directory in British Columbia celebrates its 30th anniversary. Rowena Papasin gives us a look.
Publisher Leonardo Ding Cunanan, a beloved pillar of the Filipino community in Vancouver, started Dahong Filipino with his wife Marilyn Abundo Cunanan some 30 years ago. Tito Ding, as he was fondly called by those who knew him, died last year after a long illness at the age of 85. But his legacy lives on through his son, Leo Cunanan Jr., who has taken over the reins of their business.
Minister ng tatay ko. Right from the very beginning, gusto niya na yung image ng Filipino would be a very positive one for outside the community. He was very proud na Filipino siya.
The leader of Canada's New Democratic Party, Jagmeet Singh, headed a group of NDP officials who graced the event. Singh acknowledged the contribution of Dahong Filipino in bringing Filipinos together and added that the celebration is a toast as well to the Filipino community.
It also is a celebration of the Filipino community in general, how much the community has contributed to Canada. And so we're so thankful to every Filipino across the country for everything you've done to contribute to build up Canada.
Filipino-Canadian lawmaker Mabel Elmore said that the senior Cunanan became her mentor after her election as MLA. She shared that to this day, Cunanan continues to be an inspiration to the community.
Well, I call him Tito Ding, a real inspiration, mentor for me. When I was first elected, I asked him for advice, and I really credit my success and the foundation of success for our community to his leadership and his commitment.
Burnaby Councillor Maita Santiago also hailed Cunanan for being a visionary and said she still remembers the day when her father brought home the very first issue of Dahong Filipino.
It was incredible to see your community in print then and also today. Each issue is really a snapshot kung paano yung Filipino community is of that year. And so kung titingnan natin, diba, 30 years of Dahong Filipino is actually 30 years of the Filipino community.
I have to take my hats off to him because he had this great vision for the Filipino community. And until now, it remains to be the only magazine, you know, that serves the interests of the Filipino community.
Cunanan's son, June, has not only continued publishing the magazine, he has also ensured its growth by adding a website where Filipinos can easily find out what's current and what's happening within the community.
We like to engage with the younger generation. They are the future. They know what's happening, and it's great to connect with them.
I hope that Dahong Filipino continues to be published because since I started it, it has become an institution.
Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.